If you're new to the channel, I'm Kath.
And I'm Anna Marie.
And we're the Narrowboat Experience.
We've recently decided to give up our mooring and to go continual cruising. So we've had a few things that we've had to adjust in our normal lives to make that possible. And one of the things is using the sun for power.
A few people have mentioned in the comments about getting battery packs. And just to let you know, it's something that we already had. I've got two different types of battery pack. The first one is this, and it has a solar panel built in. It has a slightly smaller capacity, and I think we can get about 2 phone charges out of one of these. So we've got more than one of these. Because we can make the most out of the sun's power and keep our phones going without having to use additional power from the leisure battery bank.
We have this 20 watt solar panel which we put on the roof of the boat when we're cruising or on days like today when we're stationary, and it kind of just works really well at collecting all of the sun's rays. You have an extra thing?
Yeah, so it plugs in, it's got 2 USB sockets so you can charge your phone, or in our case the battery packs that don't have solar on them. I've also got this extra little dongle. It works in any USB device and it tells you how much voltage goes through the device and how many amps are put out, which is really useful with the solar panel because you can use it to work out which angle is best and gives you the most output. In case you don't already know about battery packs, they generally have 1 or 2 input connections, which will be from the small end of the USB cable, like you would plug into a non-Apple product phone, and then the end that you plug in the big one. So that's where the charge goes in, and that's where the charge comes out. My battery pack also has an additional light, which is handy sometimes if you've got the battery pack and you're looking for something and you can't find your torch. This one is a higher capacity. It's 20,000 milliamps, which does quite a few phone charges. We've charged iPads and the camera, all various things from the power that's stored in this pack. So when I want to charge it, it's better if I plug 2 cables in, but because I'm charging 2 packs at the moment, so it just plugs into the voltage controller in the solar panel, and when that one's full I'll plug the other cable in there. Obviously, because this is a higher capacity battery, it will take longer to charge. I don't want it in the sun, and I just hide it behind the pack. Please don't rob me.
The packs we use for the phone will recharge 2 phones, maybe 3 if it's completely maxed out and it's sunny and it's charging at the same time. This is not a battery pack. It doesn't actually store energy, which I hadn't understood. Kath's explained it to me. It funnels the energy through to a battery pack.
Yeah, so that's the point. It'll charge anything that has a USB connection. So cameras.
But at the moment, it's taking the sun's rays and it has to be charged into, it has to be plugged into something else that you want to get power to.
Yeah.
Okay, it can't store its own power.
Yeah.
Yeah.
So that's when this dongle comes in, because it'll show me the voltage that's being generated by the solar panels and how many amps is going into my device. The one thing that's worth noting with this panel is if a cloud comes over and your phone is plugged in charging, the phone will stop charging and it won't necessarily start again by itself. You might have to unplug the cable from the phone. It's just, I don't know why it does that, but I read it in the reviews as well. So it doesn't really do that with the battery packs though, so that's good, because that's mainly what we use it for.
So those are the purchases that we made just before we started CCing. We're going to keep monitoring those and see how efficient they are. If you want to try out any of the products yourself, we're going to leave a link. It's a little affiliates link in our description. If you use the link, we do get like a couple of P for the purchase. So absolutely don't feel like you have to use the link, and also that you don't have to buy these products. If you have a product yourself that you think is better, please share that in the comments, because it's just really nice to know what's out there. These are the ones we found. Do you have any questions about power usage or water supply or anything that you're thinking, oh, when I move onto a boat, this is what I need to know about, or something that you've seen us set up that you want us to explain? We have a little bit more time on our hands these days, so we're going to try to work our way through some of the gadgets and the interesting things on our boat. So if that sounds like something that you're interested in, please drop us a comment below.
Thanks for watching today's episode. We hope that it's been useful or informative for you. If you haven't already, please do hit the subscribe button, and we will see you again soon.
Thanks.
I wonder if it's getting too many watts.